Hello, everyone. My name is Jan Marsch. I'm from Berlin, Germany, and I want to talk about OSM buildings and quite a bit about its history and maybe a few things about its future. OSM buildings is a personal project about OpenStreetMap building data, geometry data, and all those displayed on interactive maps. To be honest, the story didn't start just 3 years ago. It's quite a longer thing. And the very first thing I did about this is done in about 2001, where I created a prototype for, it was like a game visualization or game guide. And I wanted to start to show some building information on it and to get a better feeling about the environment. So I started this and, 2001, putting that big amount of polygons on a flash file just crashed my computer constantly, and I think it did for others too. So the concept just died at this time. But, the idea was still there. Then I got another chance in 2011 when I worked for a big mapping company located in Berlin. I don't know if somebody knows that. So we tried something together to make a new vector renderer. And in this case, I'm talking about a pure HTML5 canvas renderer. There's no WebGL involved, no hardware acceleration involved. So this is really pure mathematics and pure draw operations. We tried this, and the company decided differently in order to leave Google the advantage in doing 3D maps first. So I was pretty much lost with the idea, and I wanted to continue somehow. And the more or less official start of OSM buildings is 2012, summer of 2012, so we really reached the 3 years. And so I was lost with the idea. I didn't have a map engine at this time. I didn't have data at this time. I just had a concept. And so what to do? So far, I never really was into OpenStreetMap. I mean, I knew it exists. I knew it has a bit uncommon map style. But that's it. So I had looked into this, and it was rather easy to extract buildings out of it. That was impressive. So what you see here is, you need quite a bit of fantasy to recognize, but it should be the TV Tower of Berlin. Remember, we are back in 2012. And so I made this part. The other missing part was basically a map engine. So I had something before, but I couldn't use it anymore. So I was looking for something which is rather fast and rather stable, easy to use, etc. So my choice was OpenLayers. Leaflet. So I decided for Leaflet because OpenLayers at this point was quite complicated to use. So just an example. So if you're more into the coding, that's all you need to put it into your existing map project. You just require a library, you initialize your leaflet map and just add a layer to it. That's it. No special tricks needed. So, how I'm getting the data is my primary source is still Overpass API. That might change at some point if I exceed all the limits I'm currently using on the engine. But right now, it's a very good source for me to use. I'm pulling basically vector tiles out of it, just filtered for building information, do some server-side caching, attribute filtering, yes. Also aligning few attributes because you might know that the spelling of color is different depending on which continent you are on and stuff like this. All these need to be aligned, and I don't want to do this on client side. So I have a lot of preparations, but then I can easily use it. Edit some compression, and then I'm outputting GeoJSON information. So the service would be basically usable for others as well. And to make 3D buildings out of it, I mean, that's pretty complicated 3D you see here. It doesn't really require a full 3D model to be transferred. It would be enough out of OpenStreetMap to extract a footprint polygon and any kind of height information, which could be a number of levels. It could be a number of meters, feet, whatever you want. And everything else you'll see listed here, it's optional. So colors would be nice, materials would be nice, building types, etc. Those are just add-ons. Okay, so that's just quickly about the rendering itself. It has multiple layers. It's otherwise very complicated to do a full rendering of a 3D scene in a more or less 2D environment. You can't really do this. So I made a few tricks, like having elements that are very rarely updated to render them separately. And all the other objects, which are very flexible, very dynamic, these need to be rendered very often. So I'll show you an example in a bit, if everything works. So a few more tricks to make some rotational geometries happen. Probably if you're into this real 3D world, like WebGL rendering, you're not really worried about things like this, like rotational objects. You just either have them or you generate them by triangulation. If you do the whole thing in 2D, you need to do quite some geometry to make it happen. In the case of the cylinder, I mean, that's the only thing I explain. You need to create two proper circles. I mean, you have to factor in perspective. You have to add all the tangents, the relevance, and then some filling, and that's it. Ideally, it ends up with just a few draw operations to make things fast. So finally the picture to this. So that's the comparison to 2012. We have something on, we have a TV tower which looks a bit more like a cylindric object. We have some elevated objects, so like like a sphere. That's the observation part of the TV tower. You have a lot of shadows, stuff like this. So it looks a bit more, not really realistic, but I hope a lot better. So I'm trying to switch now to the video to at least to show you the first steps. Can I get this full screen somehow? Yes. Can you see it? Yes. Okay, that's just the Flash prototype. If I get this to run. Ah, okay. That's quickly, that's all the old stuff in Flash without any 3D attempts, but it's a very first slippy map. Remember back 2001. I haven't seen Google Maps at this point. So we already had some kind of interaction. Okay. So now back to this first 3D attempt. I mean, right now it shouldn't be crushing the NEPC anymore, but back in time, it was almost impossible. And you see, I mean, it's not really buildings. It's just few geometry objects in perspective. That's all. It was great at this time. All right, so can we jump forward? Okay, that's the other one. It's one from 2011 where I had just an SVG source as data file. And then I made out of this a pure vector 3D environment. So, which you can turn, yes, you can tilt. So that's what we have now. So even if everybody is talking WebGL right now, and which is very valid on all the modern devices, there are quite a few old devices out there, especially mobile, where you want to have similar things running. And this one is compatible to almost everything out there. If it can run Canvas, HTML5, you can run this. So it's still valid to have. So I give you a short demo about the shadow calculation. Right now, same scene. Okay, you can barely see it. It's in the lower right. There are two sliders for date and time. So this is real time. So there is no, I mean, I recorded a movie out of it, but the calculation is really real time. So now I need, okay, to stop it. So that's where we were last year, no, the year before. And also a few different render modes, like sketch mode, which got very popular again from, if you've seen that from MapZen, the WebGL sketchy renderer, which is very, very nice. At least I tried something in the same way using just vectors. So that's where we are now. With the whole project, I also entered the world of WebGL, finally. Almost every other project already went there, so finally I did it. And the first bigger step to get in there is, there are basically two steps. One is converting as much from the engine as possible, and also to give it a bit, to give it something unique, to add high-definition 3D models to it. That's something you see here. This is nothing rendered from the engine right now. I mean, it will be at some point. But this object is being created in 3ds Max and other tools, SketchUp as well. And what I'm trying now is to put all these together. So it's not pure OSM data anymore, but stuff added to it. The result is something like this, where we still have the rendering like you've seen it before, but now there's a tilt in the map and there's free rotation, free zooming, plus the extra model in the map. So that's where we could go. And I think it also leaves a lot of room to improve. Shadow calculation is not in there yet. Also, the horizon needs a lot of improvement, stuff like this. But basically, the WebGL part, the whole core of WebGL, is something I started just 6 months ago. So, and where we could go is probably at whole city models. If you are a bit into the topic, City of Berlin released a whole city model based on CityGML data format. It's not really OSM, but with some conversion, you could use it in a very similar way. I tried this already with OSM buildings. That's what you see here. So like a real colored city scene, roof shapes, improved building shapes, etc. I personally also want to improve the support for OSM. That means better roof shapes, and a better interface for 3D and that 2.5D mode. And of course, the HD model integration needs to be a lot better and a lot cleaner. So I show you this as well. Oh, okay. So that's still the 2.5D mode, so the one I had before. So I hope you recognize the city. If you don't, that's London, and that should be the London Eye, the upright, squarey thing. I don't know how to name that. And that's the version using WebGL. So we have a very custom model put in there. And I really hope to have a lot more in this. Yes, of course. That's a bit difficult to spot, but you can also select buildings. That was very difficult before. But now with WebGL, it's a very common task. Quick jump back to Berlin just to show this model as well. Yeah, I made those jumps just in order to show it is really, really fast. The video can't really reproduce this, but it's fast. Okay, yeah, the final jump to New York City, just to see what's the data coverage, and it is really, really good. I think that's because of the imports of official building data, and we also added a custom model to this, which is not done by OSM Buildings, but found somewhere else in the net. So, and the custom model, if you can spot that, is the metro station at World Trade Center. I heard it's not liked by many New Yorkers, but I guess the tourists will like it. Yeah. All right. So I think it's safe to stop this. So that raises one really big question. If you see that, that's in Moscow, Russia. That's what you could do in plain OpenStreetMap, or like modeling very, very detailed objects. And each of those elements you see there is a different path in OSM data. It has a lot of attributes. I mean, it reflects rather good what the real object is, but the question to me is this OSM or are we doing some 3D modeling inside a geographical database? So I really hope to get some input on this, whether we can improve or change this. Nevertheless, it's a nice model. So, and the last things is what we could do in the future, and what I'm hoping to take from this conference, is I want to create some kind of urban playground, or just a base where you can put data in or whatever you want in. I also got a lot of requests how to use OSM data, but also any other kind of city data to use it as a background for other visualizations. How to do that? And I would really love to provide a toolkit to this. Any other ideas, please contact me. What's also very clear is that there are lots of OpenStreetMap projects out there, even it feels like even more 3D OpenStreetMap projects out there. You can see a few out there on the floor, which are really impressive. Luckily, they're touching a bit different topics, but we also could join forces on this to improve a lot and maybe to do bigger projects together. And if you have an idea how to support this project to get it forward, please let me know. I'm happy to hear. Thank you.